Well, we got a Black Swan event in China. Hey, looky there. And we have a stock market crash alert. Mark your calendars for right now. It looks like we may have dodged that bullet for another day because the economy is not the stock market. Anywho, China's market trouble risks ahead. How about the entire globe, which I will show you. China in debt swap talks with bank to stave off default. And it's just not just this little one. As the Ponzi scheme continues, banks mull swapping their bonds, holding to secure debt. And oh, hey, how's that bond market? Well, I mean, I watch the bond market every day. But who is in control of the two-year yield? Well, the markets are. Who's in control of the Fed? Well, that would be like asking the question, who came first, the chicken or Jamie Dimon? He is the one in control of the Fed. I know, tinfoil hat time. It's coming in from your tinfoil hat friend. Bitcoin's at 70,000. I told you, you gotta get it before that green line. I warned you quite a long time ago, for those of you that do not currently wear tinfoil hat, I'm like, here's your swing trade, whee! And it's actually pretty simple. You could trade this thing on the monthly, on that little yellow line, okay? It goes up, you sell. It goes below it, you short it. You buy it, you short it. You buy it, not yet. Also, with what's happening in China, that does not mean short. Go over to the Chinese exchange and click sell. Just follow the charts, not stock market crash alert. As we wait for CP Live. Come on, you guys. As everyone scratches their head as inflation ran hotter than expected in February. Right? Okay, so then the market should go down. Oh, it goes up. We'll get into that in a second. I pulled Jamie Dimon up and then I didn't even talk. You guys know he owns the Fed. What percentage? I don't know. It's probably a pretty high percentage. That would be JP Morgan. So it's like that analogy, chicken, egg, bank, the Fed. The bank came first. The banks created the Fed. The Fed quasi has shareholders, like stocks. Everyone's like, oh, it's government. Just because they call themselves federal doesn't mean that they're federal. It was just a system created by the banks to do their fugazi. It's just loans. If you do want to know when Fed lowers rates, call Jamie. JP Morgan Dimon urges U.S. Fed to wait past June before cutting rates. I don't care about inflation. I don't care about anything. When he says cut, you cut. How about that? Cue the fire. This is like 1 minute squirrel time where I am able to give you every news article and put it all together and make one big black swan soup. Still have more. I have hard landings. I have individual stocks. I have markets over here. I have markets over there. And it's all different. I mean, even you take the United States of America. States in economic contraction. See, some states are like, oh, it's horrible. Other states are like California. It's great. So if you want greatness, go to California. I mean, you can flip burgers, make 20 bucks an hour. Gavin Newsom's going burr like Janet. Just because you create a bunch of bonds and give the people money and a lot of freebies doesn't mean that everything's okay now, is it? Everyone wonders why. Why inflation's still going up? Just pop the confetti. Tell Janet to stop. This inflation thing will completely go away. And also, stop listening to the news articles. And I try to bring balance, right? What's CNN say? Prices ticked higher in February. But wait, everything's fine. Because you can get this apple cider vinegar for a lot less. But there's good news at the grocery stores. Okay. You see how we can just kind of cherry pick everything? I actually like going over to CNN just because I like the balance. Gas prices have surged to 4 months high. And government, you can't really do much about that. Rent is too damn high. Okay, I'll give you that one. See, that's bad, isn't it? It's keeping interest rates elevated too. So that's how it works? I was just wondering. Here's why the Fed cares about the cost of your haircut and the doctor's visit, which is so low. What's the government say? It's like half off now, but you know, you went to the doctor. While everyone's focused on Taylor here. What's new? Business videos. Oh, I didn't know Taylor's new data reveals Taylor Swift's tour economic benefits. Is anyone supposed to make heads or tails on what is going on? China in debt swap talks. Okay, so guys, this is a big one. I will let you listen in. Does Moody's be a cutting?
This whole story when it comes to Wonka, it was just very interesting. when we were talking to Charlene Chu from Autonomous Research about this developer, right? Is this the bellwether of what's to come in the property segment? We have Moody's coming through with that downgrade, so it's now to junk. Whether we see the other agencies actually follow through is one thing. This is the statement that came through from Moody's, citing contraction in sales and uncertainties over access to funding amid a prolonged downturn. So if S&P and Fitch follow, certainly there is maybe a potential contagion risk here that we have to really contend with, Steve.
Wait, Steve, the market went up, so China's fine. Oh, and just to let you know, they have got some revenue, kids. This is not like little company, almost $90 billion. Doesn't look like their year over year is doing too well. Also, be careful when they use big words like the D word. Like always, do not trade it that way. It's big. Sorry, it's going to break China's back. Or from Bloomberg, China will fall off a fiscal cliff this year if it lets the well-regarded builder default. They're all defaulting. I mean, it is like one gigantic domino fest. Evergrande. I'm kind of excited to watch this as it rolls over here, but boy, does it not just take a long time to sink this Titanic as China merges hundreds of rural banks as risks mount. Well, financial risks. Yeah, they're basically all insolvent. You're looking at 6.7 trillion in assets. And these assets are bad loans, shrinking margins, slow growth, but we'll be fine because we have the Fed. The Fed will save us all. And again, you guys, he just makes loans. Also, I have not touched base on this one, and I will. Emergency Fed. It's a good title. It ended today. Emergency Fed Bank Efforts Ends Lending. That was a big one. Emergency Fed bank efforts ends lending as eyes turn to discount window. And I've told you, watch that one. Just subscribe and I will watch it for you. If you see this thing pop, so I got to get rid of those little banners. And it'll look like that, or it'll look like that, or it will look like that. But where are we at now? Well, I am glad you asked. We're just fine. But again, subscribe to the channel. I will tell you, when this whole thing burns down, you're going to see this line go zing. We will just keep chugging along, right? Some states, contraction, recession. It's where we at? Which one do you want? Even stocks. This stock goes up, that stock goes down. The economy, hard landings. This is actually laughable. This is macro. Again, don't trade macro. Trade the charts. The economy averting a hard landing is laughable. And companies are about to see a profit recession. This is what the economists say. This isn't Peter Schiff, Stephanie Pomboy. The U.S. Won't dodge a hard landing recession. Again, you got to wait 18 months, okay? Tightening, 18 months, money supply, give it time. The frogs are boiling, they die. The economists said U.S. consumers are already in a recession. Sure, I'll give you that. And which state? That could be followed by a double dip profit recession as corporate earnings take a hit. Correct. For the most part, not good, but we can cherry pick. Just like what state do you want to cherry pick or what AI stock do you want to cherry? It all just depends. As market doomsayer, Jeremy Grantham says stocks are at illogical and dangerous levels and warns the AI bubble will pop. Probably. Doesn't look like it's popping today. S&P 500 still in that wedge. NASDAQ, Dow, the 2000. Russell, did you come up? Oh, you down today. Talking about AI, NVIDIA popping 904. Look at you just go. That was a fun swing trade on the monthly. Do you guys see you can swing trade on the minute. You can swing trade on the daily, monthly, whatever you want. Also, take advantage of my 80% off lowest forever and ever. Today is high inflation day. Not Johnny Bravo. He bring price down for you. Also, when Netflix and all them, they raise their prices. Did I say 80% off? Pick whatever course you want. Start swing trading. Start businesses. That one, my Amazon's only 99. Then get on with your life. Oh, also, if you get frustrated with the higher fees of everything, take a look at Tubi. Free movie and TV. Fewer ads than cable. No subscription required. What are these gifts you bring us? Looks like AI is still popping. S&P 500. This is crazy. Oh, also use the money that I just saved you on, not on car insurance, but on your cable bill, right? It's like, okay, we're willing to pay a little extra. Things that you could use in life. Look, guys, look at that. Still there. Your nine count. I told you don't do it. Don't short it. Don't short it. 7, 8, 9. These swings down are just like not even swingable. Look, 7, 8, 9, purple. Still candle still on the Bravo 9 and this rising wedge. This is beautiful. What did you learn in this video? Well, China's going. Okay, we're going all over. Just depends on how you want to cherry pick this. Inflation. Oh, but I give you a discount. You can make your digits go up. Is it Friday yet? Man, this is feeling like a long week. All right, back to trading I go, and I will see you tomorrow.